You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at borisfx.com. All right, this is starting to come together now. So we are in part two of exercise 10, where we're looking at the basics of Roto continued. And we're coming along quite nicely. So if I just come and change this here, if we have a little look, what I want to focus on in this part is this arm here. So the shoulder that's coming off the at the end of the dress, and also this bit here. So we're starting to fill in gaps, and the fewer gaps we have, the better, obviously. Okay, so let's come up and we'll turn off our color overlays, and we're going to do something a little bit different in this exercise. And we're going to use a feature that is Mocha Pro specific. So if you don't have Mocha Pro 2021, just skip to the next bit, or actually just watch this and see what you can do if you do have Mocha Pro. But I'm going to come to the classic mode because I want to show you how useful PowerMesh can be when we're doing rotoscoping. Okay, so we're going to rotoscope the arm left. Now, where do I start drawing my shape with this one? I mean, you might think that I'll just come in and do like a big, hang on, let's just use X there and do something like this to get, you know, the whole arm and make that look nice and everyone's going to be happy. But there really is no reason for having to think about rotoscoping or creating such a big shape. This is mainly going to be useless. And if we create a shape this big, when we don't need to, because, you know, all we're trying to do is take the girl off of the background and not separate out skin and all of the rest of the stuff as well. If we start spending time on these big shapes, we're actually going to be doing a lot of work that is, it's sort of double work and pretty useless, really. So starting from the front doesn't really tell us what it is we need to get done to Roto. So let's just delete that one. Much more important is to find a frame where we can see that we're missing a load of information. So at the end of the shot, we can see the exposed arm, and this is where we're going to start because this is the interesting bit. Now we've got so many shapes going on, it's going to start getting a bit confusing if all of them are in red. So I'm going to come into my layer controls, go up to the overall shape outline for my completed shapes. And I'm going to turn these into purple. It means I've got a visual reference for what I've done and what I'm still to do. And let's zoom in and pan around using Z and X, as we've done many, many times before. And because we're in a Mocha Pro, I'm going to use the magnetic layer tool just to very, very quickly draw these shapes for me. I'll come a little bit further out. I'll hold down the Alt key just to freehand some of this, and then come in and sort that out there. There we go. Get rid of this point and just soften all of those up. Make sure this is looking nice because obviously as the first reference frame, we want this to look perfect. There we go. I think that's good. I can probably simplify this area out a little bit. That's fine. And the same over here, we don't need most of these lines. There we go. Or most of these points, I should say. All right, so now I have my arm shape. Now in the classic workspace, we don't have the track parameters on the left-hand side as we do in Essentials. We have the same controls down at the bottom under Motion. So this translation, scale, rotation, shear, and perspective as we've seen before. But what we also have is we have one more parameter. This is mesh. If I click on mesh, this is going to turn on power mesh. So this is going to turn on mesh tracking. Now, Mary is going to go much more in depth about power mesh and mesh tracking in later exercises. So I'm not going to go over all of those parameters right now. The only thing I'm going to do is come in into my mesh generation. I'm going to turn on adaptive contrast. Hit generate mesh a couple of times just to generate up a nice, semi-fine mesh. And I'm going to make sure that my auto smoothness is turned on in mesh tracking. The important thing here, though, for us when rotoscoping is this warp spline. I'm going to show you why. Let's call this one arm. What's it called? Arm left. That's it. Arm left mouth. Oh, no. Yeah, it's going to be arm left warp. Because we're going to be warping this one. And I'm going to make a duplicate of this and hide it. So come down to my layer controls, just duplicate that one there. Turn off visibility, turn off tracking on it, and I'm going to make sure it's down underneath my main warped one. And I'm going to just call this one arm warp. Sorry, arm left simple. We'll turn that off. Now, just to emphasize, everything is still pretty much at default. All I'm going to do now is track backwards. And this gives us this result. So we get a nice bit of warping. So we get a nice result there with the edge really hitting firmly as the arm moves up. It's looking kind of nice. Right, let's just see what happens without that warp. So I'm going to go arm left simple, turn on visibility, turn on tracking. I'm going to turn off mesh and I'll clear that mesh. So all we're doing is tracking in shear as we would do normally. I'm going to track that backwards. Let's take a little look just to compare and contrast. I'll keep the mesh simple red and I'm going to do the warped one in green. And let's give those some overlay, shall we? Overlay colors, red and green as well. And let's just turn on selected. Just so you can see the difference of what we were able to get when tracking in with the power mesh as opposed to just like the regular shear. So the shear got kind of confused quite quickly and quite early. And the power mesh has stayed really, really nice. So let's, with that in mind, let's delete the simple. There we go. We don't want that. We're not going to use that ever. And I'll turn off the overlays here. Yeah, with that in mind, let's now use that tracking that we've got to help to fill in the last little gaps that we need. Okay, so let's come in back into my Ben Roto workspace. So we're a bit cleaner. And I can also use this toolbar here, my view controls, just to turn off the mesh. So all we're really interested in is the Roto spline. So I think we can use that. There we go. So it's about there. The track itself has tracked what we asked it to perfectly. We just need to make a few changes to make it do a little bit of extra duty to kind of fill in stuff that we're filling in body, I think, rather than we're doing a bit of the back rather than the arm itself. Make sure that's looking all right. Just a little bit there, I think. I'll zoom in just a bit. Yeah, we can see we need to just fill in a tiny bit of a gap that's not being taken in by our other body layer. And because we move these points up here, these aren't sitting in the right place anymore. So we'll just come in and just fill those in. There we go. Just get that looking nice and smooth, nice and natural. With a good bit of overlap with the previous dress mask so that we don't end up with any sort of embarrassing gaps right at the very end. And that should do us. There we go. Wherever possible, if I have to change a point, I'll change it on an already made keyframe. And I think that's going to be looking all right. Let's turn on our overlays there, turn off everything else, and we'll just zoom out a little bit. And let's play that back. And I think that's worked out really nicely, with a PowerMesh and Warped Spline doing most of the hard work for us. So that means in this exercise, we've looked at how we can start to use PowerMesh, which is found in Mocha Pro, to help to speed up rotoscoping using warp splines on areas that would otherwise need a lot more kind of manual intervention. In the next exercise, we're going to fill in the last gap on the right-hand side of the screen, and we're going to do just a very quick one just to do the arm over here and start to work in on the neck as well. So join me in the third part of exercise 10, the basics of Roto continued. And I'll see you after the jump. You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects and footage, purchase the premium version available at borisfx.com.